let me introduce Mama Wilson, the swing band.
Top 10 recordings. Nobody even Elvis pour out the tea on the typewriter, because Tom Holloman's name you'd see is in there a lot. He pays me extra money, so he can do this. This is Tom Holloman, and Ed Dunn did the alto and tenor solo, and Lionel Bryson and Neil Yoakam on the trumpet. So you see, Tom's going to play another solo, and the Nightingale sang in Berkeley Square. Berkeley Square is in the Mayfair section of London, but this song actually was written in a very small fishing village in France, so that's kind of cool. And the reason it's pronounced Berkeley in Europe, unlike Berkeley in the United States, is because of the caste system. And people had their noses in the air, and they couldn't say Berkeley Square, they said Berkeley Square.
Thank you.
This next piece, we had many things we could have chosen for our last selection, because this is kind of like the classics, everything that you're hearing you probably already know and are very familiar with, because these are pieces that have stood the test of time. And we thought, well, what should we do for the last piece? And I thought, wouldn't it be fun to really rock the church? A piece by Robert Lamb, who was a guitarist in Chicago, not city, the band. How many people remember that band, Chicago?
Yes,
absolutely. And the reason he titled this 25 to 4, 6 to 4, because that's the time of night that he wrote it, 25 or 6 till 4 a.m. That's when he wrote this piece of music. So here we are.
Thank you.
song, gifted this song to UCLA to use as a rally song, and they still use it today at every pre-game football show. So I researched. I've never been to one of those songs. This is right up to me.
Thank you.
Thank you. here, raise your hand, music teachers. Raise your hands.
Yeah, so there are two of us up here. That's why we're crazy. This is by a composer, Frank Erickson, who thought that some of the band music was just not right for bands because it almost all came from symphony orchestras or operas. And it was just rewritten from those venues for band. And so he decided, and some other people about this time, he was born in 1923, and he died in 1996. But in his time, he decided, I'm going to write music just for band. So if you look through your program, you will see behind everything in there except this piece and the Stars and Stripes, it says arranged by. But this was written by Frank Erickson for a band, not for an orchestra, not for any swing band or anything else, just for band music. So we're going to present to you Rhythm of the Winds.
You should be a guest conductor if you want a guest conductor.
Thank you.
piece of music that gave George Harrison respect. He had to fight and scrap for almost every song that he got recorded onto one of the Beatles' albums. And then along came something. In 1969, it was on the Abbey Road album, and it was, in 1969, it was voted the best song for music and lyrics. So it gave George Harrison great respect from then on. So this is something. It is something.
Thank you.
for is just a genuine talent. It's Mr. Ed Martell. Think about that. Okay.